I would love to give up my This class is valuable both for leaders and followers. It's called what? It was supposed to be a fun class and kind of start out like that, but technically there's a lot of technique behind this in order to make you feel comfortable and surprised. And we got progressively more difficult. What was the first surprise?
Catch her feet.
Yeah. And ideally we're in a close embrace, so what? She doesn't see it, right? There's a beautiful connection, all of a sudden you do something, whoa, full surprise, oh my god. But when you do the first surprise, how should your partner feel when she's making that step?
Slow down.
Like you're slowing her down? Centered. Comfortable, right? Not like she's flying back. Not like you're, that she's off her balance, okay? And followers, what's the technique also for your, that's helping? What are you learning about this technique?
Smooth walking.
The middle of the step, we call it a certain flavor. We call it the caramel. The caramel of tango, as you become more advanced, you start to learn 5, 10, 50, 75, 80, 100%. You start to learn how to control your weight between your step, whether it's forward, backward, or sideways. And this is where the real fun begins. And a lot of stuff we did today has this kind of built in. Even when you're standing like this in that tight space, you're still working on the weight between the heel and the ball of your foot. You're still working that kind of weight transfer, just over your foot, finding the step. Okay, so what was, to make that a little bit harder, but funner, what can we do? For the leaders?
Pitter-patter.
Again, it's not a hard science, but there's a lot of technique now in pitter patter over the years. And this is just kind of solo pitter patter. When do I like to start it? Can we go this way? Yes, because that gives me lots of time to work with the music. Dot, 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 boom. Okay, try to bring the heels together. This is a guideline. You can start it technically anywhere for as long as you want. But for starters, use that. It sticks well with most phrases of most songs. The hard side is?
Her left foot.
Good. If we want to jazz this up a bit, we can also do what? We can communicate and ask our partners to do what?
Be different.
So what's the need for asking our partners to pitter patter with us?
With my arms? With what? My whole body, yeah? And then when you finish, settle down, maybe
one step
and then finish the sandwich.
The universal sort of standard technique for pitter-patter is you come up just a tiny, tiny bit, not too high.
Sometimes it's just about bending the knees a little bit, flexing through the knees without really changing the height. And then you're off your feet and you're ready to pitter-patter.
Okay. And it's like, in this case, holding a quarter between your thighs, trying not to drop it. Yeah, again, we're covering many different topics. All these could be a class unto themselves. What was after this? What's the next kind of major surprise that we showed you?
Tricky one.
Yeah. And it started from a rock step, 2 foot trap. Okay. Left. As she's turning to the left, my left foot comes into, she turns to my left, my left foot comes into her left.
My weight's on my right foot.
But she's not all the way, she's kind of in the middle. Right, so again, this idea of caramel. Now, as I turn to my right, I shift over to her right foot, and then my left foot can sneak in. This is one way. People have shown me other ways to do it. We are precariously balanced, right? Especially as we collect now, we're going to be in a new place, a place that you're normally not in, if you're not used to especially. Lift my foot out of the way, lift her so she collects.
So right now, my shoulders, My hip joints and my knee joints, they're nice and soft.
I like to think of a little circle, like here's the top of the O and the bottom of the O, or even the letter U, to help me move this way faster.
And I'm helping maintain that contact followers. I'm not trying, for example, to get away from it. Yeah, I'm not trying to get away. Once I feel that initial contact, I try to keep that contact on the time. How do you get out of it?
It's a good question. In many ways, I can just step back and invite her to walk through. I'll do a little demo when you'll see it. Just for expediency, we've moved on to another chapter, which technically is a little more complicated, because it involves what? For the followers? It's really, responsibility here is a lot on you to do what? Circular movement of the hero. Okay?
Yeah.
Leaders, the leads coming from where?
Shoulder.
Their spine, rotate. Okay. And followers have to have really good position and really good control of the camera. The transfer of their weight. If their weight is too fast, too much, I can't do this. There's no way I can track them. So there's a lot of control. It's even without my foot, look at Christina, she really reaches. Look at her hero technique, her Molinette technique.
So my body pretty much stays on top of my left leg, and my four corners are working as I'm making those reaching steps versus here, here.
Yeah. And then for the hard part, the leaders.
So try to see where my head is, how it's traveling versus here. That's the difference.
And then this is an illusion, although I do have to twist my hips a little bit, leaders.
Same thing, followers. As soon as I feel that contact, I'm trying to maintain it, but it's a light contact. It's not super heavy.
Or I can collect into the other position. I'll show you the demo of how to share the axis. Is that okay? I'm sorry, we went way over time.
Oh,
no problem.
But your DJ is here.
I just got here.
Setting up.
Perfect.